examine historical facts that have left Palestinian people ravaged. This is not empty rhetoric or amateur dramatics. This is a real attempt to bring the facts to the masses. Because nowadays the news is full of propagandas, and people wear shafis without knowing what Hezbollah or Hamas is. So don't be fooled by the wicked media. All my rhymes were researched in the SOAS library, because I don't trust Wikipedia. In order to see the crisis in its entirety, we need to origin the examines of Palestine from 13,005 BC. The original population were Canaanites and Philistines, pronounced Celestine, from where we derive the modern term Palestine, a place of great importance for the Abrahamic denominations. That's Christian, Muslim and Jew, so they all claimed it. Over the next 16,000 years, the country was invaded many times and mixed with a mixed population, the majority being Arab Muslim denomination, but also Jews making up 10% of the nation. The next key era to take into consideration is 17th century Europe, when Jews became victim to race hating. A movement emerged by the name of Zionism to establish Jewish sovereignty in Palestine, in the country they had the right to live in. This was during the time of the First World War, when France, Britain and Russia were united for the first time. And guess what for? They went to war for oil in the Middle East. See, things don't say change. Different acts drop different actors. Nowadays, things the same. Anyway, back at that time, Germany were aligned with Ottoman Turkey, who controlled Palestine. To simplify, the war was all about the spoils. Britain, France and Russia joined forces for the oil. They decided to divide up all the territories between all of the victor nations, with no thoughts of giving independence to the indigenous populations. Certain countries of Syria later gained independence as stated, but the British lied to the Palestinians, backtracked on the promise they made them, and claimed that Palestine had a special status. On November 17th, 1917, Britain issued the Balfour Declaration, a letter addressed to Lord Rothschild, Paris philanthropist and famous Freemason. The letter was a request on behalf of the British Zionist organization for the formation of Israel as an official Jewish nation. Now, if we add the above facts up, we're left with a simple one. I refuse to recognize Israel because it was built on blood. This is not anti-Semitic or Jew-hating, but I refuse to recognize Israel as a nation. And I don't just say that because I'm Iranian, because I believe in love for my brother man as long as my brother man is on the same thing. But what we have here is an unequal equation. They ask if Palestine to give when Israel has only taken. Yes. To paraphrase George Galloway, Israeli domination is comparable to the Second World War Nazi occupation. And the above is not an overstatement, because recent events are even condemned by Israeli statesmen. The BBC won't show certain programs because they don't want Israel to hate them, and America still has millions of dollars to donate them. Some of us go to protests, but some of us act like we gone raving. Came out for a day out and the next day we stayed in. Like the crisis in Gaza is nothing more than a fashion statement, caught up in some pseudo-revolutionary fascination. If I wear a shafi, it's as a sign of solidarity for Palestinian Arabs who lost their families. Certain people wear it because it's hot up on the fashion scene, and even print it in different colours so it don't clash their jeans. See, the whole world is selling out for cash, it seems, and it's sad to see people make profit from tragedy, but it's just become a fact for me. So if we examine the facts, we see that factually, Israel are committing crimes against humanity. They lay out a roadmap plan for peace, but tragically, that won't bring back any dead families. So check the facts and see that factually, Israel are responsible for crimes against humanity. They have no right to extend to the West Bank and sea. So check the facts and see that factually, Israel are responsible for crimes against humanity. So check my facts and see that factually, they have all been researched, so I accept any offer to challenge me. So you can check the facts and see that factually, Israel is responsible for crimes against humanity. So check the facts and see that factually, if we remain in apathy, we no longer have the right to consider our